So here we are from Mindra Water Project Information. I'm Soumitra here, and this is going to be a planned cost calculation basics for packaged drinking water plant. So this short, training, or you can say it's a detailed one, which is focused only on the aspect of how you can calculate the cost of your plant. So that is what is the intention of the training, and it is it will take you to one level further on how actually because many times it happens that you want to take a decision for the project and you are not very sure whether to go for it or not. It depends upon the budget and the money which you are required to put in. So the best way to do it, like a rehearsal first. And many times you have taken quotes from parties and you really don't know what to do further, then you purely depend upon the suppliers when they give you quotes. So I would go further and suggest you that you should not depend just merely on the suppliers and do your own studies and research. So although in our idea to actualization trainings, which we conduct for 2 days, we cover every basic, right, from Mindra Water Project Mindra Water Packaged Drinking Water, what is the ISI code for that, how to refer the ISI site and all that. But at least initially, if you are not very sure whether to even take the training or not, okay. So because coming to the training, it is also a decision, okay. Because you have to leave your place, you have to find timing and all that. So we have particularly made this training as the stepping stone, so you can use this and you can decide whether to go for that or not. Because the major thing is just the machinery cost is not the plant cost, keep in mind. So in this video tutorial, I will train you on how to do the total plant costing. So you will come to know, so what is the investment like, okay. Then other aspects like the ROI and everything, that will be later on. But at least this will be help. This will help you to arrive at your total plant cost. So let's go further. Okay. So first, let me introduce myself. I'm Soumitra Ghotikar. I'm a mechanical engineer and nearly 26 years of experience in the bottling and filling machinery. Okay. So we had been doing many projects over the years. So roughly 250 plus projects I have done with the help of my team, of course. So after doing this much things, we decided to switch over to to educate the entrepreneurs first, because there is little less kind of education for the person who wants to start the plant. A similar kind of myth is the many times people tell us whenever we tell them the cost, some cost like 75 lakhs for 2000 liters per hour plant. So they come up and say that we have got quotations that is 30 lakhs, 28 lakhs, 40 lakhs, something like that. So that is what typically happens, So once they start, doing the plant and all that, the cost go up and up and up and up. So they really don't know which cost to limit and where to stop and what to do. And then they get in such a fuss that it is very difficult for recovering the money put in also. So this training all these trainings are made for business owners or the decision makers who wish to start something in this space of water business. So let's go further. So how will you implement this training? Practice the examples given, then replace your own figures with that. Okay, make comparative statement, compare the ROI, okay, and then choose a proper business model. So this is the first step, whether or which kind of model you should go for and all that. Okay, so how to get further support from us? We are located in Pune, Maharashtra. Support hours I have mentioned. WhatsApp is 9822478111. Email ID, I would always recommend that you put your queries through email. So we usually reply within 48 hours. So let's start straight away the training now. So this is activity for calculation of full project cost. So you how much land is required, it depends upon how much area will be required, okay, to area for your total plant. So total plant area consists of open space and the covered space also. Okay. So the to decide the covered space, which depends upon what is the size of your plant. Okay. So what capacity of your plant? For example, if you are putting up a 5000 liters per hour plant, the size will be slightly different. Okay. If you are putting up a small plant for jar, the shed cost will be less. It depends upon what is the machinery and other components in that. So the starting point is you should first should know the machinery, its specifications and other components. So that will help you to come to the total cost required for construction of the shed, because you get the area. Okay. So let's slightly begin. So we'll decide that we have decided by a market survey. Again, this is one more, one more example of a survey which you can do. So if you do a survey, market survey, and you decide a product mix like something like this, 1 liter bottles, 10,000 per day. Second will be 20 liter jars, 500 per day. Then you decide to go for 200 ml pouches. Now these pouches are banned. So in place of this, you can say glass bottles, okay? Because this can be a something different kind of thing which may come up. Just for example, we have taken that. And you can also see 200 ml bottles, 5,000 per day, okay? Some states, this even the smaller bottles are also been banned because of the PET ban which is confronted. So calculation of machinery, we should go for. So we'll need to calculate blowing machine, filling machine and pouch machine and the water treatment plant also. Okay. So these things we need to see what will be the things like. So very first, let us start with this. So 1 liter, this is the total this required, what you can say, total liters. This is a pure bottle, pure water required is 26,000 liters per day is required. Okay. So what is the raw water? So it works on the reverse osmosis process. So reject water factor is there. We shall consider 60% reusable water and 40% will be rejected. This depends upon the TDS of your raw water. Okay. So TDS is measured with something called as a TDS meter or raw water analysis also. So if you want to really to test your water and do this analysis, you can send your water to us. We will do the testing and we will suggest you the plant also. This is a service which is chargeable, but you can send the you can make use of this service. Okay. So the simple approximate formula to calculate the raw water requirement will be something like this. Our pure water need is 26,000 liters per day. Reusable is 60%. So the formula can be pure water divided by 0.6. This 0.6 has come from 60%. If it is 70%, it would have been 0.7. Okay. So just divide it by that and it will be 43,334. Okay. Reverse calculation, if you do it, it will be, you will get the correct figure. Okay. So 26,000 liters per day for 10 hours. It means that the water treatment plant size will be 2,600 liters per hour capacity. So to the vendor, you should demand the costing for 2,600 liters per hour water treatment plant. Okay. Talking about other machines, 1 liter, this is a blowing machine specification. I have mentioned here, it's a blowing machine specs. Okay. So 15,000 divided by 12 we have considered. So this comes to 1250 BPH. Okay. 10,000 bottles are required. 10,000 plus 5,000, combine that, because initially you are going with the same blowing machine for both the bottles. Okay. So 15,000 divided by 12, it comes to 1250. Though we have considered here as filling machine, 15,000 divided by 8 by 60. Okay. So here we have considered 8 hours and here we have considered 12 hours. Simply because blowing machine takes more time to blow. Okay. So blowing machine will operate for little more time. So that is how it is coming the capacity. So this comes to 30 BPM for the filling machine. Why we have mentioned BPM? Because filling machines are specified in BPM and blowing machines in BPH. That's all, nothing else. 20 liter jar, 500 we have decided to make per day. So we don't need a machine actually for this. So one jar per minute or 60 jars per hour. This is what will be requirement. And 200 ml pouches here we have mentioned. You can say bottles also. So you can replace the cost with, you know, the machine or pouch packing machine, replace the cost with that. So 25 by 8 by 60, 52 pouches per minute, okay? So whatever is your capacity, you replace with that, as I told you, okay? So this is the cost. Now cost of the machinery, this is a total chart. Borewell will be costing so much, you have to take the cost of borewell, okay? For from once you know borewell also, there is some procedure, like you need to know how much water you are going to need. Now you know the TDS of the water. So from the TDS we know that 43,334, roughly 44,000 in our example, is the raw water we need daily. So you should, while testing the water, you should see the availability of the water also, okay? So borewell will be the cost, water treatment second part, filling machine, jar washing filling, laboratory, blowing machine, other utilities, other machines and other machines. Now usually what happens is, this is the area where actually to certain limit only you get the machinery quotation from people. So for utilities you don't have the quotes, you know. There are many other machines or other things which you need, like compressor, like other things are there, you know. Those also you need to have a calculation for that. So again, as said clearly, in our trainings we actually take you to detailed of resources, you know. In those detailed resources we highlight on this, and there you will come to know what is the total cost of the machines. So other machines also, as per the condition. Now if you go for glass bottles, in this case now newly cases, so this chart will be totally different, okay? You can replace that. So this is the total cost of machines. Once you know the cost of the machines, you also can calculate the cost of the shed, you know. So this is shed and shop floor template you can use. So this is all the machines again we have mentioned. So shed, shop floor, this can be had with the machinery vendor, will give you the area which you need for that each machine, okay? So you can calculate the total area and construction rate, how much per square foot you can calculate. Here also you will get a correct idea in our trainings, so how much you calculate and all that, okay? So this is one. Now this is again open plot, and this is also open plot. We in the last particular this is the thing where we discuss about the covered area, right? So the open area also needs to be calculated. So you can use this same template for calculation of open plot area. You can use, and you can use this kind of things, and you can total area required, land cost, okay? Land cost, how you should take, you should there is a trick how to consider the, if you have 10 acres of land, then only the particular land which you use, that only cost we can take, okay? And fencing, miscellaneous cost, total land required. If you, there is a trick that if you hire a shed, that land cost will not be the project cost, so you can save on project cost there. So this is how you can arrive at the total costing of your project. Once you total this out, you will get the total costing of your project, okay? So BIS and other documents, what are the required documents? So product classifications is here, bottle, jar, glass and pouch. Again, pouch is banned now. So these are the lab testings as per the ISI 14543, 2004 lab testing. So there are these kind of tests you are implementing. So besides that, how, what are the hygienic conditions for a BIS, what do they need, what are the other things required? So that complete things we cover in our trainings, you know, in the idea to actualization 2 days training when we have, we cover this in total details. So we also show you how to use the BIS website. On the BIS website you can have a number of things, you know, what are the things which you need to check. You can have a copy of the hygienic conditions as well. So in training we teach you how to refer the BIS. Besides BIS, you also need, you know, something like FSSAI license. FSSAI also has some things to see, how to, if you confront anybody, if you decide to get it done from somebody, what are the tricks to see, how to check his license, and what is the status, where they do they manufacture, what are the labeling conditions, everything we teach you in our trainings, you know. So you can refer that too. So plus list of documents is here, Udyog Aadhar Card, PCB. What is PCB? It is pollution control board, you know. So pollution control board license also you need for this. So what are the conditions for that we cover in the trainings, okay? So all required test reports for raw and pure water, pest control certificate you need, appointment letters, medical certificate workers, gram panchayat NOC, shop act license, industrial permission, of the land, land documents, private mining company, MOA, route map, plant layout, bottle design, label design, food grade certificate for the raw water storage, PVC and all that, latest electricity bill paid copy. So these all things, you know, are we cover in details in the trainings also. But you can, if you want to have a beginning, you can do like this, you know. So what you have to do is, again, I will just go to a few slides back. So this was the machinery cost thing. So here, when you are using a 20 liter jar machinery, so this will be the total cost involved, okay. And accordingly, you have to calculate your ROI and total cost of machines and the cost of other things also. The major thing is the cost of machines, then it comes the cost of covered area and cost of open area. Plus in the machinery, if you have seen, you also consider the utilities, you know. Here you can see that utilities section is there. So even in the list of machines, you can see that other utility. So these take this properly. So utilities means you have to consider electrical, electricity and all that. So this all things, when you combine it, you get the total idea about what will be the actual costing of your our services, how we help you. Sorry, we have, you know, project execution services where you are here. So we help you with vendors and your project office. So we work between you, the vendors and the project office or project coordination, whatever you think, you know. So what are the services which you offer? So we offer tri-party consultancy, you know. So tri-party consultancy is if you decided to get it done from others. So how to set that up, okay. Then add-on of soda plant to existing standalone soda plant. So if you decide to add a soda plant to existing or that, we give that, you know. Then water ATM business setup. If you want to set up a water ATM business, we give that. Then STP, ETP plants, this, if you want to set up, we can help you that. Digital marketing also, you know, we help you for setting up of any business. So what are the action points you need to go for? Yes. So first you decide the investment required and which plant to go for. Then check resources, appoint right suppliers, check our costing too, okay. So we will also give you the costing, we can give you. Execute your project well in time. And you know, this is what it is. I mean, nothing much to discuss about more. So I hope you enjoyed the video and the training. And if you need something more, you know, do contact us. So this is me again. And this is the plant cost calculation basics. So before ending, what you can do is you can download this, you know. Once you sign up, you will get this training. And do come to the live trainings which we organize. And also be subscribed to various services which we provide. Some many services are free of cost, like the podcast you can always refer, and the email newsletter also you can refer. So thanks again, and stay tuned and enjoy and start your project as early as possible. So thank you so much.